Or wait. Officially, happy weekend. Welcome to Strength. My name is Lynne. We have 45 minutes to get a total body workout in. That's my plan. We'll try to check all the boxes today so you don't have to do any more strength training today or tomorrow. Let's go ahead and start standing today. If you have a mat out, you can leave it out because we've got plenty of space, but go ahead and come off of the mat. Let's start with some hurdle steps. So standing nice and tall, we'll go ahead and lift one leg. We'll open it up, tip it, bring it back down, and then reverse that. Bring it up, around, and back in. Start with some smaller movements, getting the joints awake, muscles and tissues, then we're gonna lift some weights. Go ahead and switch sides. Let's find a few more here on this side. Balance was better on the other side for me. Let's go ahead and put both feet back down on the floor. Spread the fingers wide. Start doing some arm circles. Setting up with the feet underneath the hips are a little bit wider. And just work with your available range of motion. You'll probably find that you have more as the body gets warmer. Let's go ahead and switch directions. We'll spend a few more moments here and then we'll make our way down to the floor. Setting up in a tabletop position next. Hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips. Spread the fingers wide. Now, option, you can stay right here as you are when we go into some arm circles from the floor, or hover the knees, draw a circle each direction, one hand, and then switch sides. Actively pressing the floor away, keeping the core nice and tight. Let's get two more on each side. And from here, we'll go ahead and walk our feet out to a high plank. Spread the feet about mat width. Walk the hands in towards the feet. Stand up. Let's do a couple walkouts. Either bending the knees or hinging at the hips, plant the hands. Walk out again. Find that high plank. Hold the high plank for a moment. And then bring it back in. Stand up nice and tall. The straighter the legs are, the more stretch you'll feel in the hamstrings. Not required, but it could be a helpful movement to get the hamstrings warmed up. I have other movements to get our hamstrings warmed up today as well. The next time you find high plank, we'll take it into a runner's lunge. Stepping one foot forward, adding rotation, turning towards the lead leg, and then setting it back down, switching sides. Let's do a few alternating runner's lunges with rotation here. As you rotate, think about stacking the shoulders right on top of one another. Let's get one more to each side. Legs, open our hips, add rotation through the trunk and the spine, and then we'll walk the hands back in towards the feet. When you come up to standing, we'll find a squat stance. Feet will be about shoulder distance apart. I like to go toes out slightly. Sit the hips down and back. Press the knees wide. We see some squats today. Know that you can always return to these non-weighted bodyweight squats if you need to at any point. We'll spend a few more moments in the squat before we make a change to lunges. Let's get a couple more. After your next one, go ahead and narrow your stance. Make sure you have some space behind you. Feet stay in their own lane. Step one foot back, bend the back knee towards the floor, alternating with each repetition. Heel stays down on that lead leg. Toes press into the floor on that lead leg. Toes are pointed forward on both feet. These are looking good Saturday. We're asking some of our larger muscles to do some work and wake up a little bit. So you might notice that your body temp's coming up. That's a good thing. And that your breath starts to change. Maybe not as much as mine because I've been talking nonstop since we've gotten in here. Let's go one more on each side. Returning back to your mat, let's walk out to a high plank again. Once you get there, we'll pause in high plank. From here, we'll bend the knees and bring our hips to our heels, press the floor away with the hands, and then come back to a plank. Big bend in the knees, press the floor away with the upper body, and then extend the legs long to find that plank again. Core stays tight. Exhale back to the plank. A few more here. Last one here. Walk it back in. Find a standing position. Let's go good mornings. Hands behind the ears, pull the belly button in. Send your hips back. Keep the core tight as the hips go back. Keep your chest forward and chin out of the chest. Think about hips going back versus the knee bend. I want your knees to bend, but I want more hips back. Good adjustments. Two more like this, and then we're going to make a change. Option, continue as you are or grab a weight. With your weight, you hold it at the chest or back racket. And now we go into a weighted good morning with a light load. Shouldn't be a heavy weight here. Good. Weight is optional, not required. We'll find a few more. How about two more? Last one. Excellent. Go ahead and set your weight down. Grab squatter if you'd like. We're ready to move on. You'll want your mat nearby, and you'll want a moderate, light-ish moderate weight is where we're headed. We have two rounds, which means we'll see each exercise two times on each side, because we'll be working single side. We'll come to a half kneeling position. If you need to go standing, that's a nice option. We're going to take a neutral grip, same side as the leg that's forward, and press overhead. We'll be here for 30 seconds. Then we're going to bring the weight in front, draw a halo around the head. We'll be there for 20 seconds. I'll give you a little bit of time to switch sides. We'll do it on side two, and then we'll repeat it. So each side we do two times. If you need to be standing versus kneeling, you have that option. My clock starts in five. Palm faces the midline. We'll exhale up in two, one. Your clock is on. This doesn't need to be your heaviest load today. You have a lot of upper body work today. I hate to say we have even more lower body work today. I love a 45-minute class. I don't get to teach them very often. Usually I teach 20 and 30 minutes. So I love having the clock on my side. We have a few more reps here, and then we go into that halo. In two, one, bring it in front. Keep the chin parallel to the floor. Draw the circle around the head. And keep going. Can you try to alternate that? If you do, just keep alternating. That's okay. We'll go the other direction on the other side. One more here. Excellent. Take a break. Short break. Really, it's just transition time. Set up on side two. Clock starts in five. Go ahead and rack it. Two, one. You're on. Exhale up. Shoulders stacked on the hips. Core nice and tight. Looking good Saturday. Full extension at the top. If you need to go without weight today and just work on range of motion with no added weight, that's a nice option as well. You get 10 more seconds right here. Then we draw a halo the other direction. You don't know what that way that is, just alternate. Two, one, bring it in the front. Draw your circle the other direction. Stay tall in the trunk. Stay tall in the neck, chin parallel to the floor. Working core stability. Warming up the shoulders. Two, one, let's change. One round down, one to go. When you set up like you do for lunges. Think about your feet being about hip distance. If you need to go a little bit wider, that's a nice option, but it tends to be a habit. So if you can get the knee right in front of the hip and the bottom knee right below the hip, try it. Let's set it up. Side one, set two, and two, one. Overhead work is on. Exhale the arm extended. Activate the glutes to help with your foundation. Keep the core tight. You're halfway through this side. It can be beneficial to take the other arm out to the side and offer a counterbalance. Bicep by the ear as you press high. Can you get another rep here? Let's get one more. And let's change. Back to your halos. Once you get there, you get in. It's good, Sonia. Keep the core tight. Pull the belly button in. Your hips are going to wiggle and move around here. Tighten up the glutes. Get two more circles. Last one. And change. Nice job, Saturday. Pay attention to your setup. Rack your weight. Two, one, we're on. These look good, Saturday. How are we doing, virtual? You're over halfway through this one. Enjoy this upper body work because we've got big leg work coming up on the other side. Press one more and change. Draw your circle the other direction. Try to keep it as close to the chin and the jawline as you can. Not taking yourself out, that'd be no fun. But we should have some fun in here. One more. And time. Nice job. Grab some water if you'd like. I'll show you where we're headed. We don't need our mat for the next section. Again, there's plenty of room in here, so you can step next to your mat if you'd like. You have to do some counting. And if you lose track, then we do extra. So you have 1 minute to complete 25 deadlifts. We practice deadlifts. You get two shots with weights either at the sides or standard deadlift out front. You have 25 of them. You have 60 seconds to complete it. You might decide that you don't need 25 deadlifts today and your numbers look different. That's okay. You have a full 60 seconds to complete it. Whatever time's left over, you just rest and recover. Second exercise, with one or both weights, we go reverse lunges. We stick with one side for 30 seconds, then we go to the other side for 30 seconds. We rest, recover, we do it two times. So 25 deadlifts, lunges, lunges, 25 deadlifts, lunges, lunges. That's where we're headed. So set up your weights. If you know that 25 reps is not in your wheelhouse today, pull back, go to 20 or 15 or whatever you need. We'll do lunges together. So once you stop with your deadlifts, you recover, we'll go into lunges at the same time. We'll start in five. You're looking very ready. In two, one, let's go. You've got 60 seconds to complete it. That's plenty of time. Arms stay long, no bend in the elbow. Armpits closed in at the sides. Upper back squeezing together. Keep the arms long the whole time, even as you stand tall. No bend in the elbow. There you go. Got it. Yes. When you hit your 25 reps, you shouldn't be there yet. But when you do, set your weights down. Take a little recovery. You're 30 seconds in on your 60-second clock. How are we doing?
Let's go to the beach. Eat. Let's go get away. Okay? Okay? What they gonna say? Have a drink?
Excellent work.
It's hard. The tough part. The patrol. Let's go get it now. The sound. Now. Get some in the sound. Is it true? Three. Leave a good
pick. 10 seconds to go.
I'm on the floor. I have something more.
Two, one, everybody take a break wherever you're at. In five, we lunge. You can go body weight, one weight, or two weights. In two, one, stick with one leg. 30 seconds here. Step back into the lunge. You can keep the back foot back. Whichever variation you're in, stay in their own lane. You're on the clock now. Lesson 10. And then we change. Press through the heel on that lead leg. 2, 1. Switch sides. Right end. Whatever you did on side 1, you must do on side 2. 20 seconds to go. Then you get a break. Nice work, Saturday. 10 seconds here. Exhale your way to the top. Wait a second. 2, 1. Take a break. Good job. Good test of your grip. Good test of your legs. You see that again from the top. Grab some water. Talk yourself into it. Not out. What can you do? What are you willing to do? You're going to shoot for 25 reps again. Now you know what to expect. It might mean that you have to move a little bit faster. It's okay. Just below the knees. Don't hit your ankles. Just past the knees. Right back up. In 10, we go back in. Set 2 of 2 coming up. Ready, Marco? In 5. 2, 1, start counting your reps. 25 right here. Let's go, Chris. Back's flat. Feet press through the floor. One more. 20 seconds in. Adjust what you need. Thanks, Sonia. Excellent, Marco. Got 10 seconds. You're still working to complete it. Nice job, Saturday. 2, 1. Everybody's weights down. Set up for your lunges. Clock starts in 5. 30 seconds each side. 2, 1. You go. Solid foundation. Press that foot on the lead leg. If you're working with some heavy load this morning, I find it beneficial to try to rotate towards that lead leg. Seconds here, then we switch. 2, 1, change. Oh, nice transition, Saturday. Did you see that virtual? Oh, smooth. Halfway through this side. Yes, you can. You get upper body on the other side. Great work. Get another one. Take a break. Nice job. We're warm now, right? Yes. We have some upper body next. It's all on the mat. You have chest press coming up, floor press. Here's the deal. That's a really strong lift for probably everybody in this room. However, we have a time working against this a little bit. So I want you to go heavy, but maybe not your heaviest. Pumps and stretches. You have 40 seconds of chest press. We'll rest for 20. You go right back in for another 40. Then on your next 20-second rest, you're going to switch out your weights. You're probably going to want a little bit lighter. Skull crushers. Alternating for 30 seconds. We rest, and then we do it again. That means you're chest pressing 4 times. So grab something that will challenge you. Grab something for your triceps. Go in just about 10. In 5, you'll start your chest press. You work for 40. 2, 1, your 40 second clock is on. Go from 40 seconds of chest press to recovery. Chest press. Keep your core tight. Exhale the arms away from you. If possible, hands face the knees. If you need a neutral grip for your shoulder, then you can face the midline. You're over halfway Saturday. This one's going to build on you. Get 2 more reps. I'm watching. Get 1 more. Time. Rest. Get 20 seconds off, and then you're going to do that again. Same thing. Nice job, Kathy. Get 10. You're back in for 40. And 5. 2, 1. Activate your core. Exhale your weights up. Strong chest press. Different fatigue factor. Notice it and conquer it. I told you before we started, this is a strong lift for just about everybody in this room, if not everyone in the room. You're already 20 seconds in with less than 20 to go. If that means you have to pause, reset, and get back in, you've got time. You have a full 10 seconds here. Get another one. 1 more. Nice job. Set up your triceps. 20 seconds, you go triceps, skull crushing. If you need to take light kickbacks, that's an option. Otherwise, come back. Elbows back. Straight back. The 2, 1. The clock is on. It's 30 seconds. If you tried it and it's not for you, you can come up to standing. Go kickbacks, alternating, or at the same time. Maybe the elbows in close to you. Excellent option, studio. Let me give your heart a front row. Nice work. Let me give your heart a break. Got less than 10 seconds here. 2, 1. Take a break. Nice job. That was round 1. We have 2 of them. That's fine. Stay like that. Grab some water. You have some recovery. I want you to be able to use your arms. There you go. In 10 seconds, we do it again. 40 seconds of pressing. This is my mic. In 5. Set it up. 2, 1. Your 40 second clock is on. If you need to alternate these, that's another nice option. Let me just test. Exhale up. That's halfway through this set. You should get to a point, if you're working hard, which you are, where you start to feel like you're going to have to maybe fight for a couple of reps. Fighting. 2, 1. Take your 20 off. Nice job. Chest press 1 more time. Comes in at 15. Last chest press today. In 10, you're on. Get your weights up. 2, 1. Your 40 seconds is on. Last time. This one might take a different strategy. It might look like alternating. It might look like palms facing each other. Keep your core tight. Press your feet into the floor. Exhale the arms away. Oh, team, that's halfway. Nice job, Marco. Looking good, Amy. 10 seconds, team. Two, one. Nice job. Take 20 seconds off. Then you're back to triceps. Last time, triceps is only 30 seconds. You won't see a lot of reps if you're alternating. You want to do both at the same time. It's your workout. In 10, you're on. Then we go back to legs. Two, one. Triceps. Let's go. Lower one at a time, unless you're choosing both. Looks good, Shelly. Your triceps will start talking to you quickly because they helped you on your chest press. They have a lot to say, but tell them you've got 10 seconds left. Let's go. Five seconds, team. Leg work on the other side. Two, one. Nice job. That was good. Eventually, you have to make your way back to your feet. Not a rush, but you do have to get there. Nice job, Saturday. Get your deadlift weights out. Repeating that. Two rounds. Twenty-five deadlifts, unless you're doing a different number. 60 seconds to complete it. I'd like you to find some recovery. So if yours looks like 20 or 18 reps, that's okay. Then we go into the lunges, 30 by 30 on each side. We see it two more times. We go in five. Be ready. You look very ready. In two, one. Your 60-second clock is on. 25 reps, unless your numbers are different than mine. Strong paces. You can tell you've been here before. Tall at the top. Squeeze the glutes as you stand tall. Keep the weights close to the body. Turn the music, don't touch that. 25 seconds in. 30 in. You got 15 to finish it. Get ready, team. 60 seconds gone. In 10, you lunge. Set it up. You're on in five. Two, one. Let's lunge. And stay in their own lane. Toes pointed forward is a non-negotiable. You're halfway through this side. You're doing great, Saturday. Five seconds, then we switch. Two, one, side two already, let's go. Work. Halfway here. Ten seconds. You're looking good. How are we doing, virtual? What I see looks great. Two, one, take a break. In 25 seconds, we do it again. Last time. Last deadlift coming up. Last lunge is coming up. We have a leg burner.
Street out noon. Student girl that look like you. I guess
you're ready to deadlift. Clock starts in 5.
You move to West LA.
2, 1,
wherever
you're on. Let's go.
For that one night, more than just right. I didn't leave you, because that was so.
It should push you to a pace that keeps you in time under tension. You don't get a lot of recovery at the top because you're going right back in. 20 in. Press your feet through the floor as you stand tall. Oh, look at strong back row. Nice work.
Only upside to a downward spiral. My love for you went viral. And I'm
still working. You got less than 10.
But
finish them up.
Again, so let's skip to how you've been.
2, 1, 60 on. Get set up for lunges. We going under 10. We go in 5.
I didn't need you.
2, 1. Let's knock these out.
And frankly, scared as hell because I really fell for you.
Exactly what you need right here, right now. You're on side 1. So if that's 1 dumbbell, no dumbbells, lighter dumbbells, heavy, all the options. 10 seconds and then you change. 2, 1, side 2 right in. Don't even think about it, just get there. Excellent work. Beautiful options, team. 15 seconds. New assignment on the other side. Such a strong Saturday crew. Get another one. Finish it. Then set your weights down. Awesome work.
Here's
where we're headed next. We're gonna finish up the hamstrings. Here's what it's gonna look like. You have some swings. 20 seconds of them. For your swing, back has to be flat. And if you're using weight, weights stay high or high between the legs, and you stand tall. You're never lifting the weight. It just floats forward by all the power that you're generating with the hips. If you're unfamiliar with this movement, my recommendation, go body weight. Reach back, stand tall. If you've had some practice with it, or you feel really comfortable with it, let's go single arm. You work for 20, rest for 20, we'll hit side 2 in the next set. 20 on, 20 off, 20 on, 20 off. Done. Only time you see it. Then we're going to head to the floor. And leg curl.
Cut them off.
Maybe.
Electric. Devil eyes telling me, come and get it.
Down on our bellies, and you can do this without weight, too. We're going to curl the dumbbell up towards our hips. We'll do that for 30 seconds. We'll rest for 20, and then we'll do it again. Then we're done with those. That's where we're headed. Get set up for your swings. This is a power movement. You've had lots of recovery. You're either using weights or not. We go in 5. In 2, 1, let's go. Hike it back, stand tall, let the weight float. Body weight's a beautiful option here. Really focus on sticking the hips back and then standing up with power, keeping your heels and toes glued onto the floor. 5 seconds here, then you rest. 2, 1, take a break. 20 seconds off. Enjoy it. We'll have 1 more set of those. Not so bad, right? Get ready, you go in 5. Pick up your weight if you're using it. 2, 1, let's go. Weight stays high between the legs. It never comes below the knees. So you're literally hiking it straight back, letting it float. 10 seconds here. So we get to put these away. 2, 1, nice job. Decide your leg curl weight, which might be no weight. Down on your belly. It will sit between the arches of your feet. Setup's even harder than the curls. When you're ready, make your way in. Use the hamstrings to lift and lower the weight back down. It might not touch the floor every time. That's okay. And more seconds here. We'll rest for a little bit. Do it one more time. And then we'll be done with hamstrings for today. In 2, 1, take a break.
In the days gone crazy.
10, we do it again. Last set of these. In 2, 1, curl. Trying to isolate the hamstrings here. They've done a ton of work for you. Option to go just the body weight. Think of those big muscles on the back of your upper leg, whichever variation you're in. You have 5 seconds here. Nice, Kathy. 2, 1. Great job. Come with those. Saturday. You're killing the clock. All you have left is the finisher. Grab some water. You may want your mat. I don't want mine. It gets me all caught up. We're going to move into an AMRAP, but I know most of you have experience with those. So you have 3 exercises, a couple different options, and a 4-minute clock. Here's what it's going to look like. Matching weights are preferable. You have 4 total in Renegade rows. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Then, no, you have 6, sorry. You have 6 of those. Then you have 8 total offset squats. You'll do 4 here, then you have 4 here. If you need a different squat variation, you'll take that. Then you have 10 total skips. 1, 2, 3. You're not leaving the floor today. You're going to hang on to your weights and march for 10 total, 5 on each side. So it's a Renegade row. You can take it from a modified position if you need. If you need to do it from a bent over position, that's another option. Squat for 4, switch for 4, skips for 10, or marches for 10. On repeat. You have a 4-minute clock to do it. So find your weights. You go in 5. 4-minute clock's where you're headed. In 2, 1, start with your rows. You have 6 total rows, 3 on each side. In that Renegade position, take the feet wide. When you finish those, you'll come up, offset squat, maybe only go 1 dumbbell, and rack it or take it to the side. 4 on one side, 4 on the other, or you can just do it in squats if that's what you need. Then you either march for 10 or power skip. And then you get back in and do it again. Nice transition Saturday. You can Watch them too. Skips aren't there. Hang on to your weights. 1 minute down, 3 minutes to go. This whole finisher, this core work, and legs, and back. Let's go. Thanks, Amy. When you're in the plank's position, squeeze the glutes. You're coming up on the halfway mark, team. Good job. Two minutes to go. This is your finisher Saturday. Good choices. Full advantage of your cool down recovery on the other side. 90 seconds to go. Press the knees wide on your squats. Good. Every single movement here. Next up, go to the squat. You're doing skips with some power in them. You're doing marches. Slow them down. Great job. Beautiful variations. My only ask is that you work hard, especially at the end. You've got 40 seconds. You're coming up on the end. Finish in some work. Even if that means making a change. You're so close to the end. You have 30 seconds left. You gotta stretch and cool down after this. But you gotta get there first. Final reps are coming in. Get as far as you can. Twelve seconds, team. Find some work that you can do. Two, one, last rep, done. Nice job, Saturday.